Welcome. Welcome, dear students, in pharmaceutics first practical session. Myself, Mrs. Darshana Sandeep Shinde. Today, we deal with the experiment number 38. Title of our today's experiment is to evaluate, submit, and granules, make a granule ready for compression of two paracetamol tablet IP. Learning outcomes of our today's session. After watching this video, students are able to develop intellectual skills such as to understand the different types of the tablet, to understand the term analgesic and antipyretic tablet, to understand the different granulation process, example, wet granulation, dry granulation, direct compression, some motor skills such as skill for weighing the ingredient, skill for uniformly mixing the ingredient, skill for compressing the tablet, skill for sieving, and skill for calculating the lubricant and disintegrating agent. Then we see the preposition 1. Paracetamol tablets are analgesics, antipyretic tablet. At storage condition, paracetamol tablets are normally strip pack, but for the laboratory purpose, the granules can be submitted in a wide mouth bottle. Then we see the theory regarding the tablets. Tablets is a compressed tablets are defined as solid unit dosage form made by the compaction of a formulation containing the drug and certain fillers or excipients. There are various types of tablets designed for a specific use or function. Tablets to be swallowed. Chewable tablets formulated to be chewed rather than the swallow. Example, antacid and vitamin tablet. Buccal tablet designed to dissolve in a buccal pouch. Sublingual tablet for rapid dissolution under the tongue. Effervescent tablets are formulated to dissolve in a water with the effervescences. Then we see the new concept regarding the tablet. Tablet is categorized on the basis of their use. That is, first of all, tablet ingested orally. Compressed tablets, multiple compressed tablets, sustained action tablet, enteric coated tablet, sugar coated tablet, film coated tablet, and chewable tablet. Then the next type is the class is tablet for the oral cavity. These are the buccal tablet, sublingual tablet, lozenges, dental cones. Then the tablets used to prepare a solution. Under that, effervescent tablet, dispensing tablet, hydro or hypodermic tablet, tablet triturate propositions, and the last type is tablet administered by other routes. In that we include the implantation tablet and vaginal tablet. Then we see the properties of the tablet. Whatever to be method of manufacturing, the resulting tablet must be meet a number of physical and biological standards. First, the tablet must be sufficient strong and resist to shock and absorb to withstand the handling during the manufacturing, packaging, shipping, and use. This property is measured by hardness and friability test. The tablet must be comply with the test for uniformity of weight, uniformity of content. The drug content of tablet must be bioavailable. This is measured by the disintegration test and dissolution test. The tablet must be elegant in appearance and must have a characteristic shapes, colors, and other marking necessary to identify the product. These are the properties of a tablet or biological standards of the tablet. Tablet must retain all their functional attribution that include the drug stability and efficacy. Then we see the formulations of the tablet. The size, to some extent, the shape of the tablet are determined by the active ingredient. Drug have a very small dosage in terms of micrograms. Example, folic acid, digitoxin required addition of fillers is called as the excipient. When a drug is a very small quantity, but we have to prepare one tablet from that, at that time we have to add the fillers, and that fillers are called as the excipients. Excipients are specific according to the function. They perform in a tablet. They are classified as diluents. Diluents are soluble. Soluble diluents example is lactose, sucrose. Insoluble diluents example is calcium phosphate, calcium carbonate. Then binders, example of it, gelatin, 10% starch paste, 10% is used as binder. Then disintegrants are the starch and guar gums used as a disintegrants. Lubricant, magnesium stearate is used as a lubricant. Glidant, as a glidant, talc and magnesium carbonate are used. Glidant gives a free flowing nature, lubricant gives the lubricating action. Then anti-adherent, again magnesium stearate is used as an anti-adherent. Then we see the journey of the tablet. This is the intact tablet. First of all, this is made by the primary drug particles. These are rapidly, from that they are, we form the granules. There are number of ways to make a tablet. These granules are relatively rapid to the drug dissolution, and drug in the solution goes to the GIT fluid, absorb, and drug in, goes into the blood. Then these granules, by these granules, somewhat these granules are degraded into the primary drug, or these granules are directly absorbed. These are dissolved, and drug, they are get soluble, or they are get absorbed into the GIT fluids, and after that absorb into the blood. Or this tablet, intact tablet, low rate drug dissolution is happen, and after that drug solution into the GIT fluids, and after that absorption and drug in the blood. In this way, tablet can be goes through the blood by the different ways. Then we see the tablets are prepared by the three methods. First is the wet granulation, second is the dry granulation, and third is the direct compression. By these three methods, we can prepare the tablet. This is the wet granulation chart or layout. First of all, drug is grind, then blended with the adjuvants, then agglomerate. Here is the addition of a suitable for, in a way, for the to form a wet granulation, liquid can be added and agglomerate it form, and through the pellets or the sieve we can pass that coherent mass, dry it, then again screen off to remove the very small particles, and then again these screen granules are lubricated with the lubricant and finally compresses. This is the wet granulation layout. Then we see the dry granulation. Here drug is blend. Here is the same is one as that of the wet granulation, blend with the adjuvant, but rather than adding the liquid, here these dry granules are pellet out through the rollers, and then crush that pellet out powder, and then screen off for even size, and then blended with the lubricant, and finally compress it. This is the dry granulation chart. Then we see the direct compression. In the direct compression, drug is grind, then blended with the adjuvant, and directly compress into tablet compression machine. Then we see the while manufacturing of the tablet, various defects arise. We see the different defects in the tablet manufacturing. First is the binding, then sticking is the another one defect, then capping and lamination, then chipping and cracking, molting, weight variation, hardness variation, double impression. These are some defects arising during the manufacturing, and tablet expansion is also another one defect. Then we see the apparatus required for the today's experiment: spatula, mortar and pestle, electronic balance, sieves, different size sieves, and oven for the granulation. Then we move toward the formulation table. Our formulation table contain ingredient, quantity given, quantity taken, use of ingredient. Ingredients required for today's experiment are paracetamol, lactose, starch and starch paste. Formula is given for the 20 tablets, but today we have prepared only for the 2. That is, our formula is factor will be with 0.1. By this factor we can multiply all quantity given. We ultimately get the quantity taken. Paracetamol is used as an analgesic, lactose is used as a diluent, starch is used as a disintegrating agent, starch paste 10% is used as a binder in this preparation. Then we see the stepwise procedure. Paracetamol tablets are analgesic antibiotic tablets. They contain not less than 95% and not more than 105% of stated amount of paracetamol. The granules are prepared by wet granulation method. Wet the required quantity of paracetamol, lactose and starch powder pass through the sieve number 60. Add starch paste little by little so that a coherent mass is formed, which crumples on slight application of the pressure. Pass the coherent mass through the sieve number 10 and dry the granules at the 60 degree Celsius for 1 hour. Pass all the dried granules from the sieve number 22, below which sieve number 44 is kept. The granules written on the sieve number 44 are desired granules, and powder which passes through sieve number 44 are the fines. Then weigh the granules. Then calculate the adding 10% fines, 5% starch, 1% talc, 1% magnesium stearate. Mix the granules and powder uniformly with the help of the spatula. The granules are ready for compression and can be compressed into the tablet. Category of our preparation is analgesic and antibiotic. Dose is 1 to 2 tablet as required. Storage condition, it should be stored in a cool and dry place.
Welcome dear students. In first
semester
of
the
laboratory. Today, we deal with the experiment number 38, that is to prepare, evaluate and submit paracetamol tablets granule. Let's see the chemicals required to prepare the granules. Paracetamol granules are the lactose, starch soluble and paracetamol and starch paste, 10% starch paste. We already measure all the quantities required for our 10 tablets granules. Let's start the procedure. Take a sieve number 60. In that, add the required measured quantity of paracetamol, starch and lactose. Sieve it. Then pour powder into the petri dish to form a coherent mass. To form the coherent mass, we use the starch paste in a quantity sufficient manner. We add a starch paste into it and mix to form a coherent mass. This way we form a coherent mass of paracetamol, starch and lactose. Then we will proceed for the granulation process. We start the granulation. Take a coherent mass, place it on a granulating sieve, press through the hand. Then we dry the our granules into hot air only. Then transfer this granule into the already preheated hot air oven. Then we set the temperature and leave it for the almost 1 hour. Let us see, our granules are dry. See, our granules are dried now. Then sieve it. Pour this granule on sieve number 22 and below it we place the sieve number 44. See the granules. We collected these granules on sieve number 22, and these are the fines on sieve which we collected on the sieve number 44. Then we pass sieve number 44. These are the fines we get after the sieving through the sieve number 44. Now we weigh these granules. Weigh these dry granules. Weigh these dry granules. After that, these are our dried granules. We already weighed it. Then we add 10% fine into it. Then 5%, this is the 5% starch. Then 1% magnesium stearate. 1% talcum powder, the binder and the lubricant to give the free flowingness to our granules while it compress into the tablet. These are the granules ready for the compression. We filled it into the wide mouth bottle. These are the granules ready for the compression. Now we compress our tablet into, this is the tablet compression machine. This is the hopper, but though our granules are very little in quantity, that's why I would not place it into the hopper. We directly press on this tablet compression unit. Then we just rotate. This is our tablet. First tablet is ready after the compression. We collect all. We make a second tablet also. Clean the surface. Then add these mixed granules. Mix with the magnesium stearate, talc, fines. Rotate the punch and we got second tablet also here. We put it, then these are our tablet we made after the granulation of it by the tablet compression machine.
After goes through the stepwise procedure into the laboratory, we move toward the calculation part. Weight of paracetamol is 0.5 gram. Weight of butter paper starch paste before granulation 0.9. After granulation is 1.5. Weight of starch paste use is 0.5. Drug plus starch paste use is, that is 1 gram. Total weight or total mixture that is 1 gram. Then weight of the dry granules 0.05 gram. Weight of 10% fine 1.05 gram, weight of dry granules plus weight of fines is equal to 0.5 gram. Then dough mass contain, weight of the dough mass contain 0.5 gram, weight of the mass contain 0.525 gram. Then number of tablets is equal to B upon 0.5, that is 0.5 upon 25, it is equal to 1.05 gram. Then weight of 1% magnesium stearate 0.005, weight of talc 0.05 gram, then weight of 5% starch 0.025 gram. Then we see the total weight. Total weight can be calculated by weight of the granules plus weight of fines, weight of magnesium stearate, weight of talc, weight of 5% starch is equal to Z. Z comes 1.05 gram. After that we calculate the each of the tablet contain. This can be calculated by total weight upon number of tablet. Total weight is equal to Z, number of tablet come here. Total number of tablet come here 1.05 gram. Weight of each tablet comes 1.33 gram. Then we move toward the observation and evaluation table. It contains name of preparation, test, specification and observation. Name of preparation, granules ready for powder compression of paracetamol tablet. Description is white granule powder. It's confirmed. Odor is odorless. We confirm that test. Nature of granules, free flowing granules, we also confirm that test. Then we move toward the labeling. Labeling can be done as at the top of the label we can write the name of our preparation, then write each tablet contain or each gram contain all the ingredients with their concentration, then category, analgesic, antipyretic, then we write the dose 1 to 2 tablets as required, then we write the storage. Store in very close container in a cool place. Then manufacturing details such as licensing number, batch number, manufacturing date, expiry date, etc. Maximum retail price also included on the label. At the bottom, we should mention the name and address of the manufacturer. In this way, proper label can be maintained. Then we move toward the result. Result can be written as, here we taken the 2 grams of paracetamol tablet. We made the 2 grams of granules ready for powder paracetamol tablet IP, submitted in a well closed container with the neat label. Then we move toward the question answer session. First question is, state the two uses of the starch. Starch are used in the pharmaceutical industry for wide variety of reasons, such as an excipients, a tablet and a capsule. It is used as diluent, a tablet and a capsule. It is also used as a disintegrant. It is also used as a glidant or as a binder also. And next question is, give the other name of paracetamol. Paracetamol's here, other name ask, not for the brand name. Brand name we discuss later. Other names are N-acetyl para-aminophenol and acetaminophen is the other name for the paracetamol. The next question is, give the two marketed preparation of the paracetamol. These are the Crocin, Calpol, Panadol, etc. Number of preparations are available. Then next question is, define antipyretic. Antipyretics are the substance that reduce the elevated body temperature or the fever. That reduce the elevated body temperature are known as the antipyretic. Then the next question is, write two other dosage form of the paracetamol available in the market. These are the syrups, paracetamol capsules are available in the market. Then the next question is, classify the tablet on the basis of route of administration. Tablets can be classified on the route of administration. Tablets ingested orally, tablet oral used for oral cavity, then tablet used to prepare the solution, tablet administered by other route in oral cavity, buccal tablet, sublingual tablet, lozenges, dental cone, for tablet ingested orally, in that compressed tablet, multiple compressed tablet, sustained action tablet, enteric coated tablet, sugar coated, film coated, chewable tablets. Tablet used to prepare the solution, in that effervescent tablet, dispensing tablet, hypodermic tablet, tablet titrates and propositions. and tablet administered by other route in that implantation tablet and vaginal tablet. Thank you very much for attending my practical session.